show by giving a big cheer for Freakin' Flex and Asylum.
Welcome to another week of WAW Aftermath. We are just 2 weeks away from the first Hellbound in 3 years, and we are starting the show off with the reuniting of an unregistered, undefeated team in Freakin' Asylum. That's Freakin' Flex, Rocco, and the Jersey Devil, and they are reuniting here tonight for six-man tag team action against Full Metal Jacket. The trio of Major Morpheus Brinson and Captain Vincent Zarello are team champions, along with Sergeant Charles Hatchett. They're out here to get a measure of revenge for what happened last week. Let's take it down to Freakin' Asylum.
A tragedy, something that should have never, ever happened. Last week, Kevin Chaos made his return, and he wrestled and he never took off his shirt. I mean, with Affleck...
The real travesty that happened last week is that a longtime WAW veteran, Chateau Vanagon, lost his jaw thanks to another one of FMJ's infamous screwjobs. Seems like a week cannot go by that they can't make some kind of news by fucking somebody over. Now, I'm not going to make any excuses for me and Rocco losing the title to them in the first place. We were unprepared, they made a challenge, we accepted it. The rematch comes along. Did they win? No. They didn't hold a single pin or submission. They simply didn't lose. But they were pretty proud of that. And we left them alone for a while. But then what do? They have a match with DWI at Apocalypse, and they don't win, they draw. They go over by tie. They're still team champions because they didn't suck hard enough. Oh, they suck. They just don't suck very well. Then, when DWI tries to get a rematch, they refuse them. And then WAW comes back after a month off, DWI asks for another rematch, and they take it. Only DWI has to put their jobs on the line. Not FMJ, just DWI. So now, Troy is without a partner. Chateau Vanagon is hitting the bottle worse than ever, and he probably has an AA meeting right now. Yeah. As for us, we get a date with FMJ in 2 weeks at Hellbound.
Shut up! Not 2 weeks! I want them right now! FMJ, if you have the balls, come see your death sentence right here, right now! Come on!
And it doesn't take much time for the music of Full Metal Jacket to hit. They're sporting some new tunes this week here on Aftermath. And they are heading out here for six-man tag team action to open up Aftermath this week, as we are just 2 weeks away from Hellbound 2007. What a night of action we have for you. Our main event will be Effo and JT Lambo teaming up to take on Joey Staples and the WAW champion, Christian Sane. Sane and Effo will meet at Hellbound in absolute victory in 2 weeks for the WAW championship. But here tonight, we're starting things off with a six-man tag pitting Asylum and Full Metal Jacket in the same match. Those two teams will meet at Hellbound for the WAW Team Championship. Asylum is yet to choose their match. There's been quite a few matches heavily speculated, and I'd assume Asylum's probably going to make a selection before Hellbound, but you never know with these guys. We're a little unorthodox.
And I will blow up his shit right here, right now.
Zamir and Rocco seem increasingly agitated in recent weeks. It looks like we're going to have Rocco and Sergeant Charles Hatchett start this one off. Walk up in the center of the ring. Rocco goes behind Hatchett, belly to back takeover into a front face lock.
That's awesome.
Wait till we get in the ring, buddy.
Rocco starts this one fast, bringing Hatchet right down to his stomach. Has the front face lock still locked on, and Hatchet works out in an armbringer. Takes Rocco over, but Rocco's up on his feet, driving the shoulders into Hatchet's shoulder. And drops down with an armbreaker. Rocco just taking a ball right across the arm. Almost like Rocco had been clotheslined there, taking a fall on the arm of Hatchet. Rocco makes a tag to freaking Flex, who comes off the top rope with a double axe handle. And he falls right into the Full Metal Jacket corner. And he makes a tag to one half of the WAW Team Champions, Major Morpheus Moretzi. Flex charges once, and it's like hitting a brick wall for him. Trying for the Irish Whip, Moretzi using his power advantage here. Reversed by Moretzi. Flex ducks underneath. Catching Moretzi, send him into the ropes, going for the roll-up, nothing happening there. Moretzi misses the clothesline, coming off the ropes. Flax leaps over, drops down, and flips him over with the monkey flip. Flax now heading up to the ropes. He's on the second rope, he catches Moops, and there we go with a Hurricane Rana by freaking Flax. Dragging Moretzi over to the freaking Asylum corner, where he makes a tag to the Jersey Devils. What do we got here? They roll through a wishbone effect on that one. Good double team effort by the Jersey Devil and freaking Flax. And Rocco not too happy about that one. Rocco and freaking Flax, they've always had a rocky relationship dating back to when freaking Flax debuted. And he had a crush on Captain Vince Cizzarello, who was then Captain Amazing, then teaming up with Rocco as the Amazers. My oh my, how time can change, how the years have changed and people have evolved. Rocco and Captain Vince Cizzarello are now bitter enemies, and they used to be best of friends. And we get the kick back there by the Jersey Devil, taking Major Morpheus Moretzi down. Gonna drop the deuce. There he goes, dropping the deuce right on the chest. We got a cover, and we only get two, as Zarella was there to break up the pin. Devil taking swings at Full Metal Jacket. Moretzi breaks the hold, hammering away at the Jersey Devil, backs him into the rope, sends him off with an Irish whip. He catches the Jersey Devil trying to go for a crossbody, and oh, Jersey Devil trying to counter the fall away slam, but he got caught, and then he gets caught with a clothesline. Moretzi goes for the cover, we get two, and the Jersey Devil gets his shoulder up with a count of two. Moretzi tags out to Captain Vincent Zarello. Zarello in the ring though. They got the crossfire lock on. Driving both of their boots right into the head. That may not be the crossfire, in fact. I think I got my moves confused with Full Metal Jacket. I'm sure they'll slap me around after this match if I called that one wrong.
1, 2, 3.
Zarella with some powerful blows to the side of the head, and Moretzi taking advantage of the referee's back being turned to lay in an attack on the Jersey Devil, as does Sergeant Charles Hatchet, followed up by Zarella with a kick to the crotch, with the Jersey Devil split-legged over the ropes. And Zarello delivered a shot right to the crotch while Red Guy's back was turned. Reversing the Irish whip, going for the hip toss. Zarello tries one as well. Jersey Devil back flips over. He's got Zarello hooked and whiplash sends him back under the back of his head. What do we got here? Hatchet pulls the Jersey Devil, trying to keep him from making a tag to his partners. Oh, we got an enziguri by the Jersey Devil on Sergeant Charles Hatchet. Devil still tries to make the pin. Not happening there, excuse me, the tag. And he counters out of the belt down. Boiling point, whatever he was going to go for there, the Jersey Devil countered out. And he gets caught by Captain Vincent Zarello. Zarello hammering away here. We're going to go for a walk on the plank, and the Jersey Devil gets hung up hard on walking the plank. What do we got here? Hatchet charges. He gets caught with a complete shot. And we get a tag to freaking Flax. Here he calls it strike one. Looking for strike two. There it is. Strike two and three. And Flex calls it. They're out of here. Cerullo comes charging. He gets in with a neck breaker. What do we got here? And another neck breaker. That's two neck breakers for Full Metal Jacket. Flex ducks the clothesline. What do we got here? A head scissors takeover by the goat with the most. He has dismantled Full Metal Jacket. He's now got Captain Vincent Cerullo. He's up in the air. He's got caught by Full Metal Jacket. They're going to throw him here. They throw him right into Sergeant Charles Hatchett. Wicked Flex hangs on and takes Full Metal Jacket down with him. Rocco calling for something here. Calling for everybody to hit the ropes. We've got all three members here up on the top. What do we got? Corkscrew in. Two flying headbutts. Freaking Asylum taking Full Metal Jacket down. What do we got here? Rocco's got Captain up. Oh, going for the Hellseeker, but not happening there. Captain going for the capsize. He's got Rocco. Down he goes with a capsize. And the Jersey Devil is waiting for Cerullo to turn around. Boots in the midsection. Out of the corner. New Testament on Captain Vincent Cerullo. But wait a second. Here's Ferenczi. He's got the Jersey Devil now. Spin and around. Meltdown. What is next here? We got Flash with a toss salad on to Major Morpheus Ferenczi. Charles Hatchett coming in. He's got Flex up. Could it be the napalm bomb? And down he goes, napalm bomb. Hatchett going for the cutter.
He's not legal. I can't count.
Red guy says Flex isn't the legal man. Rocco is. He's got Hatchett in the crossface. And Hatchett taps out. And freaking Asylum wins the sixth. Hey, what do we got here? Rocco calling for a cut to music. Freaking Asylum winning this one here with a submission by Rocco over Charles Hatchett. Let's take it down. What is Rocco going
to
say?
Hey, man, Jay. Don't you have to say something to this boy?
Give him back. I'm burying him.
Shut up. I got a hostage here, and I will kill him if you don't shut up.
You going to kill him?
I'm going to
fucking jail.
I will kill him. Then.
He'll do it.
I'll kill him.
He's too low, man.
Can you go to jail? Or in the song, you want to go back in the
and
song?
And I'll be up for help now.
Get him back!
I've got your belt.
Don't hurt him!
I knew Tattoo was going to say, I just got my ass kicked by freaking Flash at Hellbound.
No,
yeah. I'm not going to do it, but you're going to pay.
Don't. Shut up!
Leave it alone!
You shut up! You listen to me now!
You listen to me! Give him back!
I am tired of you guys screwing everybody. At Hellbound, the most violent night, I show you why I'm the sickest, the most demented, the most twisted son of a bitch here, okay?
Is it Hellbound? Hey, Hatchet, do you know what kind of match you're doing at Hellbound?
Answer my, don't answer my question!
Listen, listen, I'm saying this once, say it once. Come to my home. Come to my world. I'll see you in Hellbound. Trick or treat 5!
Yeah!
And Chuck, I want you to send this to your boys. After Hellbound, when they're on stretches, these are the last three things that they're gonna hear. Die, FMJ, die!
What a blockbuster announcement from Asylum. They have chosen their match for Hellbound. It is going to be Trick or Treat 5 for the WAW Team Championship. Full Metal Jacket defending the gold against number one contenders, Asylum. Rocco says, you want to come to my world, you want to come to my home, you're going to see Trick or Treat 5 at Hellbound in 2 weeks. Hellbound, traditionally known to be the most violent event in WNW's year. It hasn't happened in 3 years, but it's already shaping up to be quite the night. We've got absolute victory, we've got the team championship, and then we've got the Hellbound match, where it's no disqualifications, falls count anywhere. What a night it will be at Hellbound, and what a night it is going to be here on Aftermath. Coming up next, we are going to see some mixing action as Bianca Wild, Riley of Crash Course, and Katie Newby will all go head-to-head in a three-vixen elimination match. And get this, Miss Moody Star is going to be the special guest referee.